Hi and good morning. This is Dr. M. Saravanan, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Commerce International Business, Sree Narayana Guru College, Coimbatore. Today, I have come with another topic on global trade and developing countries. Shall we go into the session? International trade between different countries is an important factor in raising the living standards, providing employment, and enabling consumers to enjoy a greater variety of goods. International trade has occurred since the earliest civilizations began trading, but in recent years, it has become increasingly important with a larger share of GDP devoted to exports and imports. With an increased importance of trade, there have also been growing concerns about the potential negative effects of trade, in particular the unbalanced benefits, with some losing out despite overall net gains. The importance of trade are: make use of abundant raw materials. Some countries are naturally abundant in raw materials. Example: oil, Qatar. Metals and fish, Iceland. Congo, diamonds. Butter, New Zealand. Without trade, these countries would not benefit from the natural endowments of raw materials. A theoretical model for this was developed by Eli Heckscher and Bertil Ohelin. Known as the Heckscher-Ohelin model, it states countries will specialize in producing and exports goods which use abundant local factor endowments. Countries will import those goods where the resources are scarce. Comparative advantage. The theory of comparative advantage states that countries should specialize in those goods where they have a relatively lower opportunity cost. Even if one country can produce two goods at a lower absolute cost, doesn't mean they should produce everything. India, with lower labor costs, may have a comparative advantage in labor-intensive production. Example, call centers, clothing manufacture. Therefore, it would be efficient for India to export these services and goods. While an economy like the United Kingdom may have a comparative advantage in education and video game production, trade allows countries to specialize. Greater choice for consumers. New trade theory places less emphasis on comparative advantage and relative input costs. New trade theory states that in the real world, a driving factor behind the trade is giving consumers greater choice of differentiated products. We import BMW cars from Germany not because they are the cheapest, but because of the quality and the brand image. Perhaps the best example is with goods like clothing. Some clothing, example, value cloths from Primark, price is very important and they are likely to be imported from low labor cost countries like Bangladesh. However, we also import fashion labels Gucci, Italy, Chanel, France. Here, consumers are benefiting from choice rather than the lowest price. Economists argue that international trade often fits the model of monopolistic competition. In this model, the important aspect is brand differentiation. For many goods, we want to buy goods with strong brands and reputations. Example, popularity of Coca-Cola, Nike, Adidas, McDonald's, etc. Specialization and economies of scale with greater efficiency. Another aspect of new trade theory is that it doesn't really matter what countries specialize in. The important thing is to pursue specialization, and this enables companies to benefit from economies of scale which outweigh most other factors. Sometimes countries may specialize in particular industries for no overriding reason. It may just a historical accident, but that specialization enables improved efficiency. For high value added products, multinationals often split the production process into a global production system. For example, Apple designs their computers in the United States but contract the production to Asian factories. Trade enables a product to have a multiple country sources. With car production, the productive process is often even more global, with engines, tires, design, and marketing all potentially coming from different countries. Service sector trade. Trade tends to conjure images of physical goods, import bananas, export cars. But increasingly, the service sector economy means more trade is of invisibles. Services such as insurance, IT services, and banking. A global economy with modern communications enable many micro trades which wouldn't have been as possible in a pre-internet age. Global growth and economic development. International trade has been an important factor in prompting economic growth. This growth has led to a reduction in absolute poverty levels, especially in Southeast Asia, which has seen high rates of growth since the 1980s. Problems arising from free trade. Given the importance of free trade to an economy, it is unsurprising that people are concerned about the potential negative impacts. They are infant industry argument, trade can lead to cultural homogenization and displacement effects. Infant industry argument. The fear is that free trade can cause countries to specialize in primary products, goods which have volatile prices and low income elasticity of demand. To develop, economies may need to restrict imports and diversify the economy. This isn't an argument against trade per se, but an awareness trade may need to be managed rather than just rely on free markets. Trade can lead to cultural homogenization. Some fear trade gives an advantage to multinational brands, and this can negatively impact local produce and traditions. Supporters argue that if local products are good, they should be able to create a niche than global brands cannot. Displacement effects. Free trade can cause uncompetitive domestic industries to close down, leading to structural unemployment. The problem with free trade is that there are many winners, but the losers do not gain any compensation. However, free market economists may counter that some degree of creative destruction is inevitable in an economy, and we can't turn back to a static closed economy. On the upside, if the uncompetitive firms close down, ultimately new jobs will be created in different industries. Hope the session was useful to all of you, and catch you with another set of topics in the near future. Thank you. Good day.